What's going on? What's going on? What's going on, guys? It's your boy Tay, and today I am here in the middle of nowhere, somewhere in Ohio or Kentucky. I'm not sure. I think I'm in Ohio. Maybe I'll Google it here in a second to see where exactly where I'm at. But I pulled off the highway and I was coming to actually get something to eat at McDonald's and I saw Goodwill. So I was like, yeah, since I'm on the road, I might as well stop and pop in at Goodwill to see if I can find some items, baby. Cause you know, that could be some good luck. And I have my hair on backwards because, you know, when I'm driving, I can't see because my hair be all up in my way. Even though you didn't ask me that, I was just telling you that because you never ever really see me wear my hair backwards. But with all that being said, let's go in here and see if we can find some items for profit, baby. A nice little quick trip. That's what it's about. Maybe spend about 10 to 15 minutes inside of Goodwill. Really no spending limit, but we just want to find some profits. Yeah, that's about it. But if you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. My name is Dante. We like finding profits at Goodwills and Walmarts and other random stores. But yeah, that's it. Let's go find some profits, baby. So as I previously stated, I really don't know where I'm at. I think I'm in either Ohio or Kentucky. I'm trying to look somewhere on the outside so I can tell y'all exactly where I'm at so I don't see it. So let's go ahead and try to find some profits. Most of the Goodwills are very similar. So you know me, I'm gonna hit the game sections, the DVDs, make sure I hit all the end caps and just walk around to make sure I don't miss anything. Normally I don't get a buggy, but today I think I'm gonna grab me a buggy because I feel like my luck may be good because this is a random stop and usually the random stops are the best. So let's go ahead and get our buggy and go check out these items that they have. First thing I noticed were these Nikes that look like absolute trash, so we're definitely going to leave those behind. And then I saw these shoes from a distance, these Nike Huaraches. I thought they could be good, but look how dirty they are. They are not brown. That is just the color of the actual dirt that's been sitting in them. And I don't have time to be cleaning items, especially for $12.99 for the shoe. I decided to go ahead and look it up just to see exactly what I would be missing out on. And when I check the sold comps of previously sold items, I really don't think I'm gonna miss out on too much, especially if you take into account the time that I would have to actually clean these shoes and then the profit that I would get after it's all said and done. Just not worth it, only a $20 profit. I'll leave these shoes behind and see if I can find something else.
How's it going?
How you doing?
Although Goodwill is one of the most popular thrift stores, that does not mean that all Goodwills are created equal. This hat right here in Goodwill is $4.99. I know other Goodwills that charge a dollar per hat. So it just all depends on the location that you're in. I know if you live in the West Coast, items are way more expensive than it would be if you lived in like South Carolina, Tennessee, or Georgia. But I do know prices in Florida are crazy as well. I saw this Batman figurine from afar. I wanted to go ahead and pick it up and look at it. And then once I saw that they were charging 15 bucks for it, I definitely put it back. You know I love looking at bats. This bat wasn't too profitable, so I went ahead and put it back. But don't ever be afraid to be looking at bats. I'm always down for new board games, especially when they're sealed. I've kind of stepped away from used board games unless they're really old and vintage. But I still will make sure I walk by the section just to make sure I'm not missing out on anything. Both of their board games that were sealed were very expensive, more expensive than they actually cost on eBay. Even though I don't like selling Disney toys, I did see this little Disney item. Just wanted to give it a look because you never know. A lot of little figurines can be valuable. I've never seen a bulk tape eraser before. I had no idea what it was. They wanted $12.99 for it, so that made me just want to look this item up just because of how expensive Goodwill was trying to charge. And then I see that one sold recently for 40 bucks and some are selling for 20, some are selling for 30. $12.99 only to make $15. You guys know I don't like that at all, but it has enough sale comps for it. I think I can take a chance on this item. I'm only probably going to make 10 bucks on this item, but it's $10 that I think I can actually get it sold because a lot of them have sold. Although it's a little bit more expensive than I like normally, I'll go ahead and take a chance on it. Did run across this snow globe. It's an Operations of Flight snow globe. That was the main reason I looked at it because it was just, it looked unique. It had dates on it, 1903 through 2003, which is gonna make it easier for me to look up this item because anytime you see something that's detailed like this, you should be able to type it in eBay and eBay should be able to find it, which it did. And you can see that they want $5.99 for the snow globe. People are trying to charge $30 and $19, but when I checked the sold comps, not one sold. So decided to go ahead and leave it back. I know that items can sell without having a sold comp. I just prefer to see sold comps. That's just me personally, unless it's a unique item that's very valuable. That's pretty much the only time I'm gonna take a chance on the item. We have to learn to be real particular about the items that we do grab because this is a business. As with any business, managing your money is one of the most important aspects of running it. So we want to make sure that we're spending our dollars wisely. I ran across these guitar strings. One of my friends is a bassist. He says guitar strings do really well. These, although you see comps for $15 and $20, these aren't the ones that I saw. So I'm going to do a little bit more research, and then hopefully we can make a decent profit off those items. I ran across this Aladdin thermal. I thought it was cool looking. It looked just vintage and looked like somebody may want it. But after you do check comps, you see that it's only selling for like around $9, and that's not profit enough for me. So we're going to put this item back and search for some better profits. I do sell on eBay and Amazon mostly, although there are multiple platforms that you can sell on. So I'm always using the eBay and Amazon apps to check all of my items. You can see me, I'm scanning with the eBay and Amazon app right now at the same time, just to see which platform it will be more valuable on. I'm checking sold comps on eBay, and you don't have to check sold comps on Amazon. Amazon automatically gives you a rank. In reselling in general, there are so many tools out there that helps you be able to know what items you should buy and which items that you don't. I personally don't get all the extra apps that you can use. I like sticking with eBay and Amazon because that's all you need. You can look at those, see the sold comps, and see exactly how much an item's selling for. That's all you really need. You really don't need anything fancy. And then, of course, trial and error will always be the best teacher. I love it when you can find two items that are bundled together for the price of one, or more items that are always bundled together, because let's say if one of the items don't sell, the other one may sell, and you can make your money back plus profit off one of the items. And then if the other one doesn't sell, then you can just throw it away. The goal is always try to find one item that's going to pay for everything. And then when you find items that's multi-quantitied, that always helps, because 9 times out of 10 you can make some money back. Then you see me run across this Jeff Gordon license plate. I used to like Jeff Gordon when he was driving, but he isn't anymore and he's retired. They only want $1.99 for the license plate, so I think I'm probably gonna grab it. And then, you know, we have to check these sold comps first, and one sold recently for $4.49. Not that much profit, but the buyer paid shipping. So that means if I charge shipping and just have my price a little bit more expensive, I can make at least $5 off of it. And $5 is good enough for me. You see they have a lot of older tins in here. Old tins do sell. You can see that older tins do sell. People just like keeping them for containers and putting random things in there. Also see this Mark Martin license plate, and I'm not a big Mark Martin fan, but I don't dislike Mark Martin, but they wanted $3.99 for it, so I left it behind. You guys know last year I got into plates really heavy and wanted to come check out the plates. I always look at cool designs first. Always come into the book section, always checking out the DVDs, always checking out the media. You see me run across this Zumba barbell. I have a bunch of these things already. Even though this is new and it's completely complete, I'm gonna leave it behind because I have two at the house and they haven't sold at all. So there's no point in me grabbing them. I'm not about to buy item just because it's cheap and I could possibly sell it. I don't like coulds. I always test stuff. Two Zumba's things did not sell, so therefore I'm not gonna buy another one until they do sell. You see me staring at the bookshelf trying to find some books, and I ran across this little baby book reader they wanted $9 for, but you see that people are only getting $5, $18. Not really too much of a profit margin for me, and I don't have a baby here yet, so I'm probably gonna leave this item behind. Sometimes I take 10 minutes looking at an item, deciding if I'm gonna buy it or not, but this one is just a little bit too pricey. $6, I'm definitely not gonna do it. And this is the time in the video where I please ask that you smash that like button and hit that subscribe button if you are not currently subscribed and you enjoy content like this, because it helps your boy out. So now that we're about to check out, let's put everything on the shelf and put the buggy back. But before I do completely check out, I am going to take a little sneak peek in the glass. I looked in it earlier, but I just want to make sure that I didn't overlook anything. They had some deals on the computers, but I'm not a computer seller, so I'm going to leave them behind.
I'm tired. I'm not here.
No, that's okay.
23:47. Thank you. So you always recording on your camera?
Mm-hmm. So guys, we just left the Goodwill. It's always interesting ending these videos and trying to finish them off here because I don't want to go home and finish the video. So we're going to do it here. We found three items. Think we should make some decent profit. I spent, what, 50 something dollars going to my event that I went to today, and I want to make that back. So let's see if I can make that back right now. Did I completely make the 50? Probably not, but we're going to see exactly what we did find. So in here, you see I paid $6.99 for a bunch of guitar strings. I didn't even look up what this box is right here in the back. and it says it is Eagle brand guitar strings. So yes, more guitar strings. The Fender brand guitar strings are doing pretty well. So the whole pack cost me $6.99. I saw somebody sell like a whole set for like $80. So maybe I can get a few dollars. I'm gonna get at least 20, but if I can get like 50 for all of them, that'd be really, really nice. And then we found this Jeff Gordon license plate. It only cost $1.99. That was the main reason that I did decide to go ahead and purchase this item, because it was $1.99. I'm probably only gonna make like around $10 on the item, but hey, it's Jeff Gordon. I wasn't gonna leave him behind. Saw a Mark Martin one in there, but they wanted $3.99 for that. And I was like, yeah, nah, I'm not doing that. And then we see this bulk tape eraser. I paid up for it, $12.99. I saw some people sell some pre-owned ones for like $40 and $30. Did see one or two only sell for like 20, but I'm gonna try to get that at least double my money on this item. At least double the money. That's the goal. That's the goal. So yeah, those are the three items that we walked out with. I was in there, I think my GoPro said I was in there for like 20 something minutes. Maybe a good $60 profit. Could be a $100 profit, or it could be about a $40 profit. But we made some decent money today. Not too bad, especially for a trip. I was already just on a regular road trip and I saw Goodwill and pulled in. So yeah, that's it. But that's gonna be it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching the channel. Seriously, for real, thank you so much for watching the channel. I just need to say that. And spoiler alert, your boy's having a convention. Prison of Profit Convention Part 2 is coming up. Be ready for all the details. In the next few months, we already know ticket prices will be $100, and we already know where the event's gonna be. And yeah, last year we gave about $1,000 away in the bins. We're gonna do a little bit more than that, a little bit more prizes, and a little bit better venue for you guys. But anyways, make sure that you bless somebody today, because I promise you I'm gonna bless somebody tomorrow. At this point in time, your boy Tay, I'm out.